Hi everyone and welcome back to a new episode. My name is Sergiu Gabor and I'm a quality engineer in the automotive industry. Today we'll take a look at some new LED bulbs designed to replace your old halogen lamps. Some of these products may be considered the next generation LEDs because of their absurd brightness and high power level. Of course, we'll not just look at them, we'll also test them in various conditions to find out which is the best and how reliable they really are. But I have to say, some of these products are very interesting.
The f*** is this?
Yeah, let's call that interesting. We'll first have a short overview of the products and their advertised specifications, after which we'll check out their actual power level and their light output performance, comparing them side by side to see how they stack up. We'll then continue by measuring how hot they get using a thermal vision camera, and we'll check exactly how efficient they are during those long night roads. Afterwards, we'll investigate their durability in the endurance test to see how reliable they really are. We have a lot of products to test, so let's get started. First is the Osram 2nd generation LED driving HL. This was tested previously, but because of its performance and design, I decided to include it here to compare it to the new kids. Next is a product that everyone asked for, the Philips X-tremeUltinon Generation 2. This is the most powerful LED lamp Philips has to offer, and it's absolutely incredible how much attention to detail they've put in this product, and the quality is truly outstanding. This product has the smallest LEDs that I've ever seen, and it's highly adjustable. The next product is from Auxito. It has a relatively small heatsink with a cute little fan, which I'm not sure how well it will handle the heat produced by this LED. Next is the Apollo series from X7. Like the Osram, this product was featured once before on my channel, but since we're comparing the best of the best, I've included this one too.
The V45 from Bevinsee is their next generation product, and this has big shoes to fill.
Moving on to Infitary, another highly requested brand. Next are three products from Novsight, and I've organized them by their packaging color because I have no idea how these are called. First is the Novsight Blue, which is almost identical to the Auxito product. The Novsight Orange is a chunky boy with a big heatsink, but not as heavy as I expected, giving me a feeling of cheapness. The Novsight Green features a unique design and feels like a premium product. Last but not least are the final two products, both from Boslla and both very unique. First is the Boslla Pro RGB series, which features a second RGB LED. For added effect, I guess. They also have this two-tone design with half of the product being green and the other half being red. But I have to ask, Pro stands for professional, right? Like these products are intended for professionals? What kind of profession would that be?
Hey buddy, you think we're fucking amateurs?
And second is the Boslla Bullet series, which has three illumination modes, possibly making it very useful in some situations. This product can offer cold white illumination like the rest of the bulbs, but can also provide this hybrid warm white color with a yellow light mode for increased visibility in foggy conditions. Yeah, and this stupid flashing mode, which is useless. So, those are all the products, and we'll start the tests by checking if you get a warning light on your dash when using them. The Osram Auxito, Novsight Blue and Orange, the Boslla FOG all show a warning light when using them, at least on my car. Next, we'll check the actual power of these products using my power supply. Here we have a table with the values reported by the manufacturers on the left and my measurements on the right. Feel free to pause the video if you wish to take a closer look, but we'll summarize everything towards the end. For this test, the products will be installed in both a reflector type headlight and a projector type headlight. The difference between these two is that the projector uses a lens to distribute the light, while the reflector relies on a mirror behind the bulb to do this. So, if your headlight has a lens, it's classified as a projector. In order to get a fair opinion about the performance of each product, I've set the camera to manual mode to avoid any automatic color and brightness compensations. So, let's get to it! This video was supported by Anki, a video surveillance company that offers products designed to keep your house or business safe with 24/7 video surveillance. They've sent one of their best-selling cameras that looks really good and has 2K video resolution, night vision, two-way audio, Alexa compatible, and local storage. Of course, I couldn't recommend the product if I wouldn't have tested first, so I've been putting it through its paces for the last 2 months, using it inside, outside, in hot environments, cold environments, as well as humid environments. The only struggle I had was with the mobile app, which needs some work, Enki, to make it more user-friendly and easier to set up the camera. But once it was done, I haven't experienced any connection issues and everything worked fine. This camera will be sent to one of my Patreon members, but if you need one, it's only $60 at the link in the description. Many thanks to Enki for supporting the video. Now back to our bulbs to see what exactly happened. Starting with the reflector headlight, let's first evaluate the light intensity, comparing it with the classic halogen. The weakest product in this comparison is the Osram, having 2898 lux, which is less than the classic halogen. The Philips is a little better, having 5778 lux, or 71% brighter than the halogen. But the main star was the Apollo X7, which had an eye-melting value of 10,445 lux, which is 210% brighter than the halogen and almost twice as bright as the Philips. Bevinsee is in second place, with the Novsight green in the third place. Regarding the light pattern, only Philips offers a relatively even road illumination and recreates the light pattern of the halogen. For your reference, I've marked the center lines with red so you can better see the deviations in light projection. This is a left-hand side headlight, so there are a few key spots that need to be properly illuminated. On top, the cutoff line needs to be clear and no light should bleed above it. We can see that both the Boslla and the Osram bulbs fail in this regard. On the right of the beam pattern, the light needs to dip in order not to blind oncoming traffic, and Philips sort of achieved this. Now for the projector headlight, we can clearly see that the lens is helping a lot with the light pattern distribution. Once again, the Apollo X7 is the brightest, followed by Bevinsee and the Novsight green. Despite being almost identical to the Auxito, the Novsight blue offers the weakest performance by far. As for the light pattern, the lens is doing a fairly okay job at providing a clear cutoff line with most of the products. However, the high-power LEDs do have some light bleed above this, which will piss off other drivers, but also offer a much wider area of illumination below the cutoff line. For the Boslla FOG, the cold white light mode offered the highest light output for both the projector and the reflector headlight. LEDs have a big drawback, and despite being generally more efficient than classic incandescent light sources, LEDs get pretty hot and require a cooling system to keep their temperature at a safe level. But as LEDs get hotter and hotter, they get less and less bright. This is important because manufacturers often advertise the initial brightness of these products when actually, for some of them, you can lose up to 50% of that figure due to poor thermal management. So, all LEDs tested in this video have active cooling except for the Osram. This means that they have a built-in fan that keeps them cool. We'll first use a thermal vision camera to check how hot these products get. Afterwards, we'll measure their efficiency and their noise level. Bevinsee reached the highest temperature in this test, peaking at 125 degrees Celsius. The Novsight green had the second highest temperature of 118 degrees, and third is Infitary, peaking at 115 degrees. The best result came from Philips, peaking at 63 degrees, followed by the clown car and the Boslla FOG. A really great performance from Philips and a worrying result from Bevinsee. Surprisingly, the Apollo X7 reached 85 degrees, which is much lower than I expected, taking into account how bright this product is. Now, for the efficiency test, I used a high-sensitivity light sensor hooked to an Arduino so that I can log in the data. For the moment when the lamps are switched on, you can see that the light output starts dropping until the lamps reach a steady temperature. So, let's take a look at the Auxito product, which had the worst result in this test. As you can see, the initial light output started at just below 4000 lux. But after approximately 7 minutes, the light output reached a steady output of around 2800 lux. This equals to an efficiency drop of about 29%. You may be asking, what is this drop right here? Good question, glad you asked. That drop is present on all the actively cooled products, and this is the exact moment when I blocked the fan from cooling the lamps. As the light temperature rises, the light output decreases even more. So, this is the normal operation of the bulb, and this is without the fan removing excess heat. The brother from another mother, the Novsight Blue, has almost the exact same profile as the Auxito and has an efficiency drop of 28%. The Apollo X7 lost 16%, Bevinsee lost 24%, Infitary 23%, Novsight Orange 15%, Novsight Green 20%, Boslla RGB 12 and the Boslla FOG 15. The Philips lamp had a very interesting result. For a second, it recorded a very high light output, after which it was very consistent with just a 2% drop. The burp you see right here is when I stopped the fan. At this point, the bulb started flashing and didn't stop until the fan was working again. But you can see Philips too lost some of its brightness as the temperature climbed. The Osram, being passively cooled, has a less aggressive curve, losing approximately 18%. Okay, so now let's take a listen to these products and measure their sound level. To me, this is not that important because the sound produced by these products is covered by the engine anyways, but some people might be interested in this aspect. Well, obviously, the clown car is the loudest, and the quietest is Auxito. Now you know. For the final test related to the endurance, I decided to check if these products can withstand harsh environments. So, high humidity, freezing temperatures, and vibrations. I didn't test on-off cycles because LEDs are very reliable in this aspect, and it's not something to worry about. For the humidity test, I sprayed water on the products as they reached their operating temperature and also left them to soak overnight. Fortunately, none of them failed. For the low temperature test, the LEDs were left in the freezer overnight at minus 30 degrees Celsius. In this case, the fan from the Philips bulb did not immediately start when it was switched on. So either it was frozen or it doesn't work when the bulb is cold and doesn't require cooling. In the end, cold environments have no negative effects on these products. In the vibration test, the products were dropped repeatedly for 24 hours to simulate vibrations present in the headlight. And again, all products survived. Yeah, well, when it comes to reliability, LEDs are great. But now, let's summarize the results and see what are the conclusions. Starting with the Auxito and the Novsight Blue, because they are basically the same. I can fairly say that the only advantages of these products is the relatively small form factor and the low noise level. But their light output is on the low side, they are the least efficient in this video, and you also get a warning light in your dash. They are not even the cheapest, but if you really need one, go for the Novsight, as it's $14 cheaper than Auxito. My rating for this product is, you can do better. Speaking of cheap, the Novsight Orange is the cheapest in this video at $31. It has relatively okay light output and efficiency, but the light pattern is not that impressive. It also looks and feels cheap, shows a warning light in your dash, and it's pretty big, making it hard to install. Overall, my rating for this product is, you can do better. The Infitary and the Novsight Green are very comparable. Both cost around $60, both provide okay light output, and both are error-free. The light pattern is relatively okay for both headlight types, but definitely not excellent. They get a little too hot and their efficiency is not great. My rating for this is okay if it's cheap. Now, for the Boslla RGB, I'll better let my professional colleague discuss about this bulb. Come on. You can have the seat, come on. Goddamn right I can have a seat. I'm a professional man, everything about me is professional. I have the iPhone Pro Max or whatever. Okay. Hello. What are we talking about? Ah yes, the multicolored RGB light. I mean, what else do you need in your life besides RGB lights on your car? There's nothing more important, man. I mean, look at this. Oh no. Look at this. Proper RGB lights, man. What's this temperature and light output shit? You don't need that. All you need is RGB lights, man. Put on a show, boys. Come on.
Okay, that's enough.
What?
Go back to your tent now. Come on.
No fun around here anymore. Getting all serious and shit.
Come on.
Back you go, Mr. Professional. Bye. Take care of the elephants.
Well, that was weird. In any case, the Boslla RGB, pretty okay light output and efficiency, but good God, using that RGB function is seriously cheesy. I have no idea in what kind of circumstances you would use that, but if you need something like this, you'll have to pay $160 for them, which in my opinion is a comically high price. Also, the light pattern is horrible for the projector headlight. My rating for this product is, you can do better. As we're talking about Boslla, their other product focused on yellow light is actually something useful. I really enjoy that this bulb can mix cold white light with yellow light to produce this unique light pattern, which I believe that it would help you with visibility in poor weather conditions. Also, the light output is fairly decent in all three illumination modes. Unfortunately, it's a little too expensive and it also shows a warning light in your dash. Besides this, having two LED arrays affects the light pattern quite a bit. Therefore, my rating for this product is okay if it's cheap. Now, the Bevinsee V45, a very capable product with a couple of flaws. This LED has the second highest light output in this video. It's incredibly bright and it has a decent light pattern, but the thermal management is not great and the efficiency is also on the low side, losing around 24% of its light output in the first 3 minutes. I'm not sure how much this will cost because it wasn't released yet, but I expect it to be around $100, which is a decent price for what you get. With this in mind, my rating for this product is almost excellent, but not there yet. The Apollo X7 is the brightest LED that I ever tested. Period. It also offers great efficiency, it doesn't get too hot, and the cost seems decent at $109, probably a little expensive. The only drawback of this product is the availability, as it's only sold in the United States. If it would be available worldwide, I would have given it a full rating. But my rating for this product is almost excellent, but not there yet. Osram really underperformed in comparison with all the rest, offering really low light output for the price. But they released a more powerful product that is road legal, making it the only LED approved for road use that I know of. However, it's only approved in Germany, Austria and Croatia. Moreover, it's rated at 19 watts, so I don't think that it makes a huge difference in light output performance. The LED tested in this video does have some advantages though, as it's really compact, has a good light pattern and good efficiency. My rating for the Osram LED is, you can do better. And finally, Philips. And I was so curious to see how this product was. I expected it to blow my eyes out, but as MKBHD would say, expectations are the thief of joy. And that's very true. I mean, it's not bad, it's definitely better than the halogen, but when compared with the competition, it struggles. It's very efficient and has the best thermal management that I've ever seen in an LED bulb. Also, the light projection is probably the best in this comparison. But at $200, man, I would have liked to see it among the best products. Because of that ridiculous price, my rating for this product is, you can do better. If I would have to choose three of the best products from this comparison, I would have the Novsight Green in third place, Bevinsee in second, and the Apollo X7 in first. So there you have it, my review and opinion of some of the best LEDs currently available on the market. Some of these are really great choices and you can find them available on Amazon, AliExpress or directly on their website, but I'll leave links in the description for all of them if you need them. Let me know in the comments what you think about them. Have you used any of these products and what's your experience with them? Have I missed any testing aspects that you would be interested in? I'm very curious what you think. If you enjoy this kind of videos, please consider subscribing to the channel and liking the video, as more will be available soon. Next up, I'll be testing some air filters with some surprising results. Stay tuned for that. In any case, thank you very much for watching and I hope you have a great day. Bye bye!